I'm Tiziana Rubin, and don't be afraid, I will speak about food either. So, So, I've been working for 7 years in the Museum Department of Coop Culture. I'm in charge of marketing and sales department for the Northern Italy area. And I worked with the Jewish and not Jewish organization of tourism for the last 12 years, okay? Today, I'm going to tell you something about the best practice run by Coop Culture in the Jewish heritage, okay, related to the Jewish heritage. First of all, I will explain what is Coop Culture. Coop Culture is one of the most relevant cooperatives operating in Italian cultural heritage and activities. Coop Culture offers customer service and communication activities for visitors, booking, pre-sale, ticketing system, digital platform for promotion of local realities. And our contribution to the sector of arts and culture cannot be limited to economic funding, but can be measured in terms of the sector sustainability. Our very important goal is try to integrate cultural heritage with the local economy, culture and tourism. We run more than 165 museums of cultural places all around Italy, okay, from the northern Italy to the Sicily. We had very well-known places as such as Doge Palace in Venice, or Colosseum, or Valley of the Temples in Sicily, and some smaller realities that we love and try to promote, okay? So, we are at the service of the Jewish heritage and we cooperate with the APJ. And the meeting between Coop Culture and the Jewish world dates back in 1989, when the Jewish community of Venice entrusted its museum to an external partner. And for a whole year, we worked in synergy, planning all the activities, the permanent exhibition with the Jewish community of Venice, and training the staff in Jewish culture and religion. Here below, you can see, I put some pictures just to show you how lucky we are working in such amazing place, but what a huge responsibility we take on our shoulders. So here, this is the Jewish ghetto of Venice, one of the two squares that we have in the ghetto. I'm running a little bit, I'm sorry, but I made I maybe overdone a little bit with the presentation, okay? So this is Campo de Ghetto Novo, in which the Jewish Museum is located. Here, the same square, okay? And in Campo de Ghetto Novo, there are the first three Venetian synagogues. You will see this one. Okay, look at the windows, the five windows. Is the Italian one? Is the German one. The other one is the Italian one. And over there, there is the entrance of the Jewish Museum. There is another synagogue that is hidden in the corner, okay, and it is named Canton, that means corner in Italian in Venetian dialect. Those are some buildings of the Jewish ghetto. And here you have picture from the ghetto and one parochet that we have in the Jewish Museum. You have to think about the museum not just as a place, okay, just a museum, one building, but it is a widespread museum, open-air museum, because we have the square of the ghetto, the old ghetto and the new ghetto. We have the synagogues, and that are five synagogues in total, and the Jewish Museum, the Spanish Scola Garden, so we have a lot of places, okay, not just one building. Here's some picture from the five synagogues in Venice, and where we do guided tours for tourists. This is the Spanish synagogue. This is the German one I showed you in the ghetto square before. And this is the Jewish cemetery on the island of Lido. That's why I was speaking about an open-air museum, because it is located also in another island, okay, nearby Venice. And this cemetery was born in 1386, okay, and it is the first evidence of the Jewish presence in Venice. Here you have the bookshop of the Jewish Museum, the ghetto square with the students waiting for a guided tour, and again the German scholar. In this period, due to the pandemic and important restoration works, a large part of the museum and some activities I'm going to talk about now are temporarily suspended, and we are going to think about how to change it, okay, and to do it again. So, how do we keep the museum alive? We do organization and promotion of cultural events, organization of exhibition, meeting with the authors, communication and advertising, assistance to the Jewish community for inter-museum loans and the restoration work, coordination with the various city institutions, and implementation of new technologies. The food. Okay, here you have the bookshop with the kosher cafeteria. So we made some tasting tour also over there. Right now the museum is closed, so this is a picture of the 2018, okay, before the restoration works start. Here some works of the restoration. And here cooking lesson. The man you saw in the picture is Michele Campos. He's a member of the Jewish community of Venice, and he helped us to do cooking lesson about Jewish traditional dishes, using, for example, for Pesach or the challah for the Shabbat. Okay, this is a picture of the bookshop we had in Meis in Ferrara. And now I would like to talk about a little bit about new technology where we use in Jewish heritage. So the first one, scusate che togliamo questa. Okay, meglio. This one is Mapot. In 2016, with the partnership of UAV University, we developed an app that show how Venice has changed from the 16th century to the present days. I will show you a couple of pictures after that. Mapot works using several ancient maps. The first one is the Barbary from the 16th century. The second one is Combatti from the 1856. And the third one is a Fotopiano from the 1982. And so, using the app, we put some point of interest, and you can see how it is changed in the times, okay, from the 16th century to the present days. Now, we have started to work again on this map to do some online tours for tourists with contents inside, so pictures, videos, information, not only related to the Jewish ghetto, but to the Jewish life all around Venice. Because we usually think that the Jew used to live only in ghetto. In Venice, that's not true. A lot of wealthy family after the 19th century has building on the Grand Canal. So that's why we need something like an app to show the importance of the Jewish life in Venice Island. So, other pictures. Another app we made is Audio Culture. audio culture is at the service of cultural heritage, and it is an audio guide that you can download from your mobile phone directory, and you can use it to discover some museums, some places where Coop Culture is working. We use it in some, small museums. Okay, so everyone that can go here can discover the museum also without a guided tour, because a lot of time in the small museum you don't have the guide available for anyone. Okay. With the pandemic experience, the COVID-19, we decided to develop a platform that is called Live Culture. And it is a platform that allow operators to do virtual tour. Okay, you can use it with a full HD video visit, social games also for students. Okay, to involve the students to use it. Scusate. All the contents inside of Live Culture are created and curated by archaeologists and historians that work with us. Working for the Jewish Museum allowed us to create a combined ticket for multiple sites. Okay. And from our experience, this is the best way to support the less known location. For example, if we have a combined ticket for the Jewish Museum in Venice, in Padua, in Ferrara, in Florence, and in Siena, okay, I'm quite sure that the tourists that come to Venice and maybe is thinking about going to Florence can visit also Padua and Siena, okay? So it's a way to support the museums that are less known usually, okay? All our tickets can go directly online on the website of Coop Culture. This is the reservation page. This is the website. I'm running a little bit. Okay, so this is another website. The name is Art Planner, and this website collects in one virtual place all the offers about Italian Jewish heritage. We work with the APJ to use it also as a starting point to build an European website dedicated to the Italian Jewish heritage. Okay. Here you can see some of the page from the mobile form of the Art Planner for Jewish heritage. The name is Italia. And over there you can find all the information about museums, kosher restaurants, activities, and you can book it also. Something about Jewish educational that we do in museums. We think about the creation of activities that are related to identity, history, culture, and an immersive museum experience. So, some picture. This is the landing page of the Jewish Museum of Venice for students' activities. Okay, with all the offer. And some Jewish museum educational activities that we are carrying on, and I think that are very important for the Jewish heritage. The first one is Historians for a Day. Is an activity where the students discover through the archivio, the story of one people of the Jewish community in Venice. Okay, so we divide the students in group, and each one has to look of the documents like birth certificate, wedding certificate, or something else. And the students can discover, thanks to one singular life, the Jewish community history in total. And then there is moment of in which all the students speak about what they have discovered. We Are Out of Play is a kind of same format, and it is about sport and fascism. In Venice, we do it focusing on the life of Giorgio Salvadori, that was a swimmer during the fascism. And the same here, the students, we guide students to understand the history, the fascism, okay? Analyzing the life of this swimmer, Jewish swimmer in Venice. Silent Play is a sound performance, okay? We use wireless devices, some buds, okay? And allow people to have an active and immersive experience in, with the Jewish traditional novels, okay? So they are using the devices, and there is an actor that tells them some novels about Jewish history. And the people has to, there is also an interaction, because the actor sometimes say, okay, now take the hand of the people that is behind you, now look him at the, in the eyes. And we do, we used to do it before the COVID with people that don't know the other one. So it's funny to see, it's funny also for the people. And involve the people in the visit that they are doing. Our first silent play has been set up for European Jewish Culture Day, and it was dedicated to the storytelling, so it's quite about the storytelling. And now we have also the one about Shabbat, in which the people listening all the information about Shabbat can in the same time taste a little bit of the alot, do the kiddush with the wine. So it's a five senses experience, okay? Not only listening to someone that is explaining something to you. Okay, for we do some events that, for different audience, but I think you you know, okay, the topic. So upgrading teachers, lesson, Jewish music concert, guided tour and kosher appetizer, okay, to explain also the kosher rules, and exhibition with Jewish artists, and historical meetings. And we have done for, this is one of the best things I think we have done in the Jewish Museum of Venice for the commemoration of Anne Frank's 19th birthday. We have organized a marathon, a reading marathon in Campo di Ghetto, and 19 people read a passage of her diary during the whole day. When we wrote a banner on our website asking who wants to participate to these events, we receive, I don't remember the number exactly, but anyway, if we can keep going with the experience for a whole week, okay, people all over Italy asks us to come to read a part of the diary. It was a really an incredible experience, and really I think one of the best things we have done to engage the citizen, and not only the citizen, the Italians people. We do also online communication, such as a website, social media, thematical campaign, and site-specific artworks. Okay, I'm running, so we create a new website for the Museum of Padua, Venice, and we are right now creating the website for the Jewish Heritage in Pisa, if you want to check it. We manage the social media, such as Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and we have thematical campaigns. that are not relating only to the museum. Okay, so we are not speaking about the museum. Here you have the parochet made from blah, blah, blah. But we speak about Jewish cinema, Hebrew languages, books, kosher receipt, music, everything that is related to Jewish heritage. And I have to say that is working really, really well. We had a lot of followers, a lot of interactions, so it works. We have done so also a couple of site-specific artwork. Through the some actors, okay, we made an artwork that tells the history of the most important people in the Jewish history of Padova and Venezia. And the one in Padua, that is called Generation to Generation, so Midor Ledor, has become a DVD right now. So, and they are using it also right now. It's a very good artwork and useful also for the people that are going to visit the museum and don't know very well about what they are going to see. Okay, because Padua usually is you know Padua for La Cappella degli Scrovegni, but not for the Jewish Museum. So, I want to thank you, everyone here, the EPJ, the Cultural Roots, that allows me to attend 3 days experience, and also the Italian Jewish communities that entrust COP Culture and me with the valorization of their heritage. Thank you. Question? Okay, thank you.